Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti U7 Pro Outdoor. We already have the Ubiquiti U7 Outdoor. The Pro Outdoor adds the 6 GHz frequency to the setup. Not a big technical overview, not a performance review. You'll find more of those over on our YouTube channel. This is about what you get in the box and how it all fits together. So let's get on to that. You're gonna start off with a get started guide. You probably might not even take that out of the wrapping. Warranty information is in there as well. You're gonna get this little guide then. This is out of the box. You can run it without the antennas on. I'll show you with the antennas on it in a moment. It's a directional. You get about 90 degrees by 90 degrees this way, this way. I think in 5 GHz. And one of them I think is about 45 degrees. It will show you on here. When we add the antennas on, it gives you 360 degrees from the antennas in this circling space, as well as still giving you directional from here. And the 6 GHz is only available directional here, not from the omnis. So I'll maybe talk a little bit more about that as we fit that together. So that will actually show you actually how that's broken up and the coverage that you get from it. You're then going to get a number of ways of mounting this. So this is our wall or solid pole or solid wall mounting bracket. You can see here the screw holes that we've got. It is a full sort of more like a knuckle joint or even more than a knuckle joint. So we've got up and down movement and sideways motion. You'll also see on the back here, we've got these cutout grooves. So this can go onto a pole and then we can use the metal zip ties that we're given to go through the holes that you can see just here and zip tie that to the pole. So you're going to get that as your main mounting bracket and that you'll actually see goes into the plate that I'll show you a little bit more at the back and fixes into place. So we'll just keep that to the side there. So you are going to get your drilling guide with your level on here for those four holes if you're going to wall or I was going to say ceiling mount, but you're probably not going to ceiling mount it, wall mount it. You're going to get a number of packets of screws and lugs to fit all of this together. You are going to get a hex tool and Allen key to help you do up those once you've got your fitment in the right way. Again, I'll show you how that all goes together. Then we sort of start to get a little bit more interesting of how it all goes together. So let's just look at the back of the device. Let me just show you, it's polycarbonate on the front here. We've got a big metal heat sink on the back, which is obviously pretty solid for how this all fits together. So if we look at our mounting bracket here, as you can see, it's going to clip into the bottom and then we've got a screw hole that's going to screw that into place and hold it there. And then we've got our flexibility to move that if I show you in our vertical position and then again in our horizontal position. So we've got quite a lot of control over how to actually mount that. And then obviously that's what's screwed into the wall. So let's take that out. You then have, I'll move that to the side so it's not confusing what you do. So like I said, you then have the ingress for your cable. So we've got two options here. We can mount this and it can be fairly watertight. Maybe you're gonna put this under the eaves or something like that of a building. So our cable is gonna come in. This is gonna be mounted. Remember, I'd always recommend you have a drip loop. Let me just bring that up here to show that better. What do I mean by a drip loop? If you're gonna have a cable like this and it's gonna come in from the underside, then do come down and round and up before you come through the wall or however you're gonna tie it back. That means any moisture that gathers on here or on the cable is always gonna come to the bottom of the cable here and drop off the bottom. And it's not gonna try and capillary action back inside here. So let's just bring this back so we can unclip this. This is going to expose, it's got a nice little tie to stop it falling off. This is going to be expose our Ethernet port. This is a PoE plus powered device. So do make sure you've got the right power on your switch or a PoE injector. You can see our little reset hole in there. And so obviously that's where your cable comes up. If you wanted to, we can then upgrade our rating for this by using this. So we can actually pull our cable up through the inside. This little grommet comes out and we can actually pull our cable. If we take this out, I'll show you, we can pull our cable through here. It actually all comes apart. I think I can show you that. Well, if I can't, I can show you the actual component. You get a rubber bung here so probably doesn't show well under the lights. There you can see you can pull that apart, pass your cable through it, even if it's already terminated, through this portion. Then obviously this is going to fit now into the top of your setup here, and your cable is now going to come up through the hole in the bottom. And then we can, obviously you've passed your cable through there, don't do it in the same order I've done it, otherwise you'll never be able to put that back on. That's going to then do that up, squeeze that tight, and actually give us a water seal. This piece here, if we now unscrew this screw here and remove this plate, we could actually now, with the screws in the packet, screw that into place. And that's actually going to then seal down and give us more of a watertight seal here at the back. Obviously, our cable's coming in the bottom. We now can mount that directly onto a pole like that. So there is an alternate option there. And that's why we have a couple of extra grommets here that we can use to fit that all together. So let me just put those out of the side as well. So we've had a look at those. And we'll just take that off as well. And we'll just put this back on here. Just to show it all together. Now, like I said, this is directional. You can use this 90 degrees this way, 90 degrees this way. You need 2.4 and your 5 gigahertz in this scenario. I think one of them may be only 45 degrees, but it's very directional. Now we have the option, we can take these off and we can put external antennas. Now, if you have had an access point from Ubiquiti that's outdoor, you may be used to the ones that we call rabbit ears. They maybe have a joint in the middle so they can be bent at an angle. These don't. These actually have some very specific fittings that you can see that you actually push it in place and screw this down till it goes tight. Again, you can see how this goes through here. So you pull it, push it in, and you can now fit that in the plate in place and then do the antenna up. So these don't actually flex this way, but you can see how that actually looks. Now you can see, if this was mounted this way vertically, probably not a great example, let's imagine, your wireless signal 360 is going to come out like this. So you can maybe use this bracket to give you a little bit of maybe downward look like this, so that we again have 360 out here. But we do have a directional from this as well. So getting the best out of this is really going to be about how you mount and where you mount this unit. But I do hope that's been useful. I'll pull it up here so you can see it a little bit better. That's the U7 Pro Outdoor. It supports wireless 7 and wireless 6, wireless 5. It's a 2x2 in the 2.4 gigahertz frequency, a 2x2 in 5 gigahertz, a 2x2 in the 6 gigahertz directional here. We can add this on to give us omni support as well. Hopefully that's been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. Plenty more box openings on network, firewall, and wireless how-to guides there as well. So why don't you subscribe and stay up to date?